You already know Apple has AirPods, and now Google has Buds. Okay, so these are Google Pixel Buds. They're $159, and because Google makes them, you know that they come with some really neat Google Assistant features. It has this little magnetic charging case, and as you can see, they're neck buds. They're not truly wireless earbuds. And when you put them in, they look like this. Let's take a listen. The Pixel Buds come in this little case, which charges the earbuds. And you should know what you're looking at here is a dummy model. It's not the real thing, which is gonna be slightly tweaked from this design. But I did get to try a working version later on, so I do have some impressions. Anyway, like I said, they're neck buds, which means there's this little cloth cord that connects them. They come in three colors, white, gray, and black. The cord conveniently wraps around the case here and it closes with a magnetic snap. I did find it to be a little bit fiddly for me to wrap, but Google says again that it's tweaked the final version of the case to make it better. The Pixel Buds fit in your ear in a kind of interesting way. This little cord on the earbud can be adjusted to serve as an anchor inside your ear. You adjust it out to a fit and then just plop the things in. They don't do any fancy auto detection when you're in your ear though. The battery lasts about 5 hours and it can be charged 4 times from the case. Oh, and they also pair automatically with a Pixel just like the AirPods do with an iPhone. Okay, but what do they sound like? Well, I'm no Vlad Savov, international connoisseur of headphones, and I only got to listen for a few minutes, but to me, they sounded like pretty solid for earbuds. They don't go into your ear canal, they sort of sit outside so you can still hear the world around you. But that said, they managed to get way more bass than they have any right to. To control them, you use the touch sensor that's located on the right earbud. Tapping is play and pause, you swipe forward for volume up, and you swipe back for volume down. Unfortunately, you can't skip tracks with the touch controls. You have to ask the Google Assistant to do that for you. Now, Google has said that it plans on issuing automatic updates that could enable new features like skipping tracks, but there's no guarantee that that's going to happen, there's no timeline for it, and you should know that those updates are only going to come if you have it paired to an Android phone. Oh yeah, wait, the Google Assistant. That's the whole point of these earbuds. To use it, you just hold your finger down on the right earbud, ask your question, and the Google Assistant answers you. It's really, really fast. The earbuds actually start recording and then sending your audio as soon as you put your finger down, so you don't have to wait for confirmation beeps or whatever else. You can also pair them to an iPhone and they'll work with Siri, but honestly, they're way better on Android, if only because it gives you access to a very, very clever new feature, automatic translation. The Pixel Buds with your phone can translate 40 different languages. What you do is you hold your finger on your ear and you say your phrase, and then your phone translates it for you. The person you're speaking to can then speak back into your phone and you'll hear the translation of what they said directly into your ear. I don't know if doing this is going to be any less awkward than just passing your phone back and forth like you can do today. It's just another thing we're going to have to test out when we do the full review.
As you can see, they're not quite as whiz-bang as Apple's AirPods. Instead, they're something a little bit more pragmatic, and pragmatic is nice, but like any headphones, we really need to listen to them a lot in a full review before we can tell you if they're any good.